So we can write a letter of appreciation also. If something nice has happened, you were very happy, you know, like, of course, about a cleanliness drive in your locality, or about, you know, how the security is maintained, or it was a public event and you noticed that how everything went very smoothly, right? Or yes, so people coming together, helping others in times of crisis. That is something that we need to appreciate. But we rarely do that because we have a habit of complaining. And we think the letter to the editor, it's a platform where we complain. Okay, right? Yes, so I have my subject. I have my salutation. Now, when I talk about the content part, you all know that. What is there included in the content? I give my introduction. Yes, what comes in the content? What else comes in the content? I've given my introduction. Yes, I talk about the problem. I talk about my solution or the suggestions also. And yes, of course, you give a request that all this should be in your newspaper. Okay, right? So one thing is very clear. So where do we write a letter to the editor? It's written in the newspaper, isn't it? Right? Because our receiver's address is always the address of a newspaper. Yes, so letters off to the editor, they are written in the newspaper. So what is this called? This is called, yeah, you can see it is your content also. And this is the, so this is the body of the letter. So which do you think is the most important part of, yes, so the body of the letter is most important. Okay. Now, generally, I've written a letter, I end it. And it does not generally happen in formal letters, right? In separate, formal separate, okay? Right, I'm talking about. Sometimes when we write letter to friends, relatives, your cousins. So after writing the letter, you remember something. Oh, this was something very important I wanted to share, right? Yes, so we write something as, after I've written the letter, maybe after I've written the message, I write something called PS, right? I remember, oh yes, the dress code for my birthday party or the color code is blue. You know, you forgot the most important thing or anything other trivia you forgot, okay? Right? So PS, PS is postscript. And it is not a part of formal letter. In formal letters, yes. Please note this down. So you can get a question here. What is not a part of the clause? So when I talk about the complementary clause, what is there in the complementary clause? Your subscription is there. How you end? Yours sincerely, yours faithfully, yours truly. Right? Name, designation if given. It is there or not? Yes, so when you write official letters there, so it is there. Postscript is not, okay, a part of a formal letter. What is an enclosure? If I say I'm writing a formal letter, I have here, say letter of complaint I am writing. And as a proof, yes, I bought this refrigerator from your shop. I have added the receipt, the bill, right? What is that called? Enclosure. Nature of letter, the kaisi letter likhi hai wo, right? Okay, fine. So here, before I start with writing a letter, let us remember little details. Okay, so enclosure bhi ho sakta hai. Kiska part? Formal letter ka. More specifically for complaints. Right? Okay. For a job application also, yes? Wo bhi last mein aata hai. Subscription humne likh diya. I've written here. Yes, I've written yours truly. ABC. I've given my designation also. Say I'm the president of this society. Then I have put a enclosure. Okay? Right? So it is, what is the enclosure? It is, say, the copy of the, say, registration of the society, anything there, right? That is an enclosure, anything you include with the letter. Where will all this come? This will come at the end of the letter. Now, if you get a question that what is not a part of the, you can say, the ending of the letter or the complimentary close. So I say date, right? I say enclosure. I say subscription. I say designation. Date is not there. Very good, right? So where date is a part of the heading. Okay, little things you have to remember. So one thing we have learned today, when I write formal letters, there will be no postscript. A manager ko, editor ko, right? We don't say, oh yes, I just remember that incident happened on, say, 22nd September. No, I have to be very particular about what I write. Okay, right? So this can happen when you write friendly letters. Okay, so right. So quickly now, just take a look here. What comes after the receiver's address? Subject. Okay. What comes between the salutation and the receiver's address? Subject. Okay. Right. So what can be included in the content part? Okay. So can I include enclosure in the content? I can't, right? I can include a mention of it. I can talk about it, right? But enclosure right here, specifically referring to it, it would be at the end, okay? Right? So if I say here, what is the tone of writing formal letters? Polite, formal, right? Formal is more appropriate. Of course, politeness has to be there. Personal, some if an option is there, we'll think twice about it. If I'm writing a letter of complaint, it is a personal experience I'm talking about. Okay, right? Yes, isn't it? Right. So here, please remember little details. Fine? Yes. Now, yeah, let's come to the next part. That is, let's write a letter. I have to write a letter complaining about, so let's complain, or highlighting the issue of, what do you want to highlight? Something very common which is happening nowadays, yes, what could it be? Yes, Instagram Reels. Oh my, we're going to discuss this with the editor, how it is affecting the public, banning it, right? What else? Theft, so increasing cases of thefts. Okay, come on, write the letter here. Come on, write the question. You have to write a letter to the editor of a leading newspaper highlighting the problem of increasing number of thefts post-COVID. You are highlighting the increasing number of thefts post-COVID, right? So you can say in your neighboring, in your society, a neighboring society, okay? So I can make it the increasing number of thefts, T-H-E-F-T-S, right? In your neighborhood, the post-COVID period. What is post-COVID? After the COVID. Well, actually, are we over with COVID?
No.
Sort of, you can say that considering the number of cases here, they've gone down, and let's hope it remains like this, okay? That the situation becomes better. Right. So here, if I talk about, let's start here. So I have been given what? You're writing, whom are we addressing the letter to? Who's the receiver? Editor. What have I given you any address? What have I mentioned? What have I mentioned? Leading newspaper. So if I say here, right, you want to talk about this issue, which would be a better choice? Can I talk about it in the anything? Options are given. Which would be a leading daily in which you could address your problem? Times of India. So let's identify the leading newspaper. Okay, all those these might be there, but are they going to talk about your current affairs? Are they going to talk about your problems? No. So they are very specific about the problems that they deal with. So what is our subject? What would be an appropriate subject for this letter? Can you suggest what could be the appropriate subject? Yeah, so even if I write very briefly, so increasing right, I would like to highlight post-COVID, yes? So three are enough, okay, for the time being. Which would be the best option? Deaths are increasing in a neighborhood. Increasing cases of thefts post-COVID. And stop thefts in a neighborhood. Is it appropriate at all? No, it is not. So you have to select which is the appropriate. And of course, subject has to be very, very relevant. It has to be a brief, glimpse of what your letter is going to be about. Okay, right. So we're going to talk about this here once again. Right. So what are the things I would like to highlight in this letter? So if you have to talk about the content part, you're talking about the body of the letter. What are the things you need to highlight? We're talking about increasing number of thefts. Yes. So what are the things you would write in the content part of the letter after your introduction? What do we have to write about? I'm writing my points. You write yours. Don't look at the blackboard. Online students, look at your notebook. Come on, write your points. Chirag, don't look here and there. Come on, write a few points. You can write. Why? Write, of course, here. Yeah. Why are we writing? We're writing this because of the increasing thefts. Okay? How it is creating a sense of what among the people? Sense of terror or a sense of insecurity. You cannot leave homes unattended. Yes, someone has to be at home, right? And of course here, what is the consequence of this? So is it only homes or elsewhere also these thefts have been taking place? And we're reading in the newspaper, it is actually happening. It is actually happening. So yes, Jasleen? Yeah, of course it is. 2 points you write? What did you write? Come on, let me hear your valuable inputs. What? Right, so unemployment has increased. That is why they're happening. Yes. What all comes in the content part? What am I going to write in the content part? Am I going to write about the problem? Yes. Am I going to write with the cause of the problem? Yes. I'm going to give suggestions also. So why not? So add some more points. I've talked about the problem I have here. Yes. So what is the problem? Yes. So let's start here. So alarming increase in thefts. As a result, what is there? There is a sense of insecurity among the residents. They are not able to leave their homes unattended, right? And yes, here, anyone in particular who's being targeted? Is there any particular target? No. So it is, yes, so any home which is there, they find vacant or they find, you know, like owner not there, it is target. Is there a modus operandi or is there a proper way that they operate? Yes. Yeah, so is it only one, you know, odd case or it is happening, you know, in the neighborhood areas at a regular frequency? Yes. Yeah, so, yes. Yeah, so, right. You can say, right. So regular and of course you can say the frequency in surrounding or in the neighborhood areas also, right? What happens here? We talk about, okay, we should have CCTVs. Yes, we talk about, yeah, we should have the watchman, right? In your locality should be there, making sure that your locality is safe. In spite of this, it is happening, right? So in spite of all this, yes, so the CCTV cameras are there. Even then, they're smart enough. Of course, it does hardly takes a minute for them to cut it off, isn't it? Right? Or maybe, yeah, the watchman is not attentive or they, you know, get friendly with the watchman and then they are able to get access to the houses. Right? So, yeah, they give a part of the loot to the watchman, is it? Yeah, so the watchman is also not bothered. So what else? Yes? So what is happening? You filed a number of reports here. What about it? What action has been taken? Yes, so no action has been taken. You can say no trace of the robbers, right? Now give your suggestion. What do you want to be done? What do you want to be done? So strict action has to be taken. That is our favorite line to write. What else is there? What else? So there should be more patrolling. Yes, right. And of course, we want that. We have, you know, the neighborhood. Am I getting the spelling correct? Yes. A neighborhood security, or you can say the youth or the residents coming together and forming a group which is responsible for the security, right? Secondly, of course, we do have a gated colonies, but that is not a very viable option, right? Yes, so we want strict action, at least to restore the faith. We want more patrolling. Yes, during the... So if the public and the police come together, things can be changed, right? And of course, here we have left out one thing, that why you think this is happening here. You can say it is because of, yes, unemployment is there. We have people who are drug addicts, yes, and people who are there, you know, looking for easy money or someone who has inside information, right? So they are the ones who are there, okay, right? What else do I need to write in the letter? Please look at the content part. What else has to come? Yes? Then comes the, I wind up my letter. Enough? Sure? Right? Our MCQ manner. Look at us. We stopped using our brains. I told you, letter writing, I'm going to do subjective. यू नीड टू यूज योर ब्रेन. देन ऑल ऑफ अ सडन हमने क्या अपना बटन ऑन करना है एमसीक्यूज के बाद. ओके लेट्स स्टार्ट राइटिंग एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट थिंकिंग मोर. इज इट वी गोना चेंज? Yes. Right. So you have that nothing is being done, and we need action at least to restore the faith of the public in the police system. So how are you going to? Can you suggest a suitable conclusion for this letter? So this was your conclusion here. Yes, that more patrolling and so as to restore the faith of the public in the law and order system, right? And of course here, yes, so people are doing their best. Nobody wants that their home should be robbed, right? So everyone is taking proper precaution. But yes, here we need our legal action, and we need our police also to step up. Okay, how do I conclude the letter? Kya likhte hai fir? I'm writing to the editor. What do I want the editor to do? Right, so what is the editor supposed to do? He's going to come with his gang and patrol the area. What is he going to do? How is the editor going to make this change here? He's going to highlight the issue. So we request him to, yes, to highlight, print this letter, give some space in your newspaper. So what will happen? So the concerned authorities can take action. So what is the purpose of writing a letter to the editor? The editor is not going to solve your problem. No. The editor is going to highlight it. And how is highlighting this problem going to solve it? People can read about it. They become aware. Okay. And yes, so the concerned people can also take action. So it will reach the authorities there. Right? So why letter to editor? Why not go directly and complain? Why not go and complain here at the police station? It will not be highlighted. Very good, right? So here, why is it that we write the letter to the editor? Because one person is there making a complaint. It's not going to make much of a difference. I write a letter to the editor. It will be highlighted. The public is going to read it. Okay. So when I give a complaint, how many people will know about it? A few people will hear. But when I write a letter to the editor, how many people will be aware of it? Number of people, more than that. So what will read it? What do we call the people reading here, or the people I'm able to reach out with the letter? Very good. We call them the audience, right? Of course, generally we should say they are the readers, right? So if audience or readers is there, you know that yes, it has to be this. Okay. So when, No. Letters which you write to the editor, they are not charged. But other things that you want in the newspaper, you talk about an advertisement, you want to put a notice, you want to put a missing notice and all, right? Or you want to put an advertisement about your product. So they are charged, okay? And please here, you need to be creative. Just because they have multiple choice questions, that does not mean that we have thinking cap off. So on the go.